In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. What a great season we are about to enter into, the Great Lent, a journey that leads us to the celebration of Pascha, the season of seasons, the Feast of Feasts. An early video communication, Father Jim, so beautifully summarized the purpose of our life as an Orthodox Christian. It is a journey. But what does the Great Lent prepare us for? What is it taking us to? And what is Lent? Why do we fast? In Mark 9:29, our Lord replies to his disciples, complaining about their lack of ability to drive demon out of the little boy. This kind can come out only by prayer and fasting. Jesus himself fasted 40 days before being tempted by the devil on a mountain. Matthew 4:1-10 shows us that if Jesus fasted, then we need to fast, since fasting is extremely needed tool for our spiritual well-being. It's a spiritual exercise that gives us the power, through the grace of God, to cleanse our soul and purify it, to let Jesus come and dwell in our heart. The Great Lent, that is characterized by prayers and fasting, is needed to drive out our demons from us. It is upon us. We're entering it next week. So let us take advantage of this spiritual time and walk through it. A journey that will take us to Easter, when we see Jesus' triumphal moment against death, when we will shout, "Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those in the tomb bestowing life." In this journey, the church takes us through 5 weeks, preparing us for that powerful day. On every Sunday, it teaches us, it puts us face to face with a living example that conquered himself or herself and proved to be Christ-like in devoting the entire life to serve the Lord. First Sunday, Sunday of Orthodoxy, where the church celebrates the victorious winning of the Orthodox faith against heresy and false teaching, the faith that the church inherited from the apostles and from Jesus himself. Keeping the correct faith and living according to it is the first step, very needed step, toward heaven. That is why the church had safeguarded the faith, the correct dogma, by shedding her own blood in the process. The church lived and is living her faith, and it's inviting us to do the same. But how shall we do that? The second Sunday of Lent is called Saint Gregory of Palamas, a living example of how we should keep the faith of the apostles and live according to it. He did that by living under simple rule: stay away from everything that takes us away from Christ, and do only these things that bring us closer to him, the light of lights. So to unite with him, to fulfill Matthew 5:48, be perfect as your Heavenly Father is perfect. A powerful verse from the Gospel, well understood by the Church Fathers. We can become by grace what God is by nature, Saint Athanasius of Alexandria. The third Sunday is the elevation of the Holy Cross, Matthew 16:24-26. Then Jesus said to his disciples, "If anyone would come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for me will find it. What good will it be for a man if he gains the whole world yet forfeit his soul?" Clearly, brothers and sisters in the risen road, the cross ultimately is our own way of life, enduring our tribulation, enduring our troubles with thanksgiving, gratitude, faith, will allow us to give ourselves to God as a burnt offering that pleases to Him, the Light of Lights. When we carry our cross, living the Orthodox faith of the Apostles, then we should be able to participate in the resurrection of Christ. The third Sunday in this journey will show us a glimpse of such a glory. St. Paul in Corinthians 1:9 says, "No eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has conceived what God has prepared for those who love Him." The fourth Sunday of Lent is for St. John Climacus. Marks the beginning of the second half of the Lenten season. Another living examples the Church invites us to follow. But this time, it's his book, The Ladder of Divine Ascent, that the Church is inviting us to read and live by, useful with the blessing of our spiritual father in our war against the devil over our mind, soul, and body. The book provides us with tactics and spiritual advices that will allow us, if followed, to emerge victorious, as did Saint Mary of Egypt and all the saints. The fifth Sunday, you guessed it, it's Saint Mary of Egypt. Is carrying one's cross possible? Saint Mary of Egypt, an adulterous woman, showed us an example who one can retreat to his or her inner desert so to concentrate on facing the root of temptation and answering to that question, yes, carrying one's cross is possible. Once you kill the root of the bad plant, the entire plant is killed. Saint Mary did so. So we can do the same. We can dry our own sins out of us once and for all, so we can witness to Jesus' miracles of raising Lazarus of the dead as his victorious entrance to Jerusalem as a part of the journey of the cross. The end of this week, Friday before Lazarus Saturday, marked the end of the Lenten season and the beginning of the Holy Week. We pray that the Lord God will grant all of us His grace so we can journey throughout the seasons and emerge victorious against our own weak nature, ready to witness to the whole world that Christ is risen. Indeed, He is risen. Amen.